On my second day alive, I was instructed to see the beauty of an island that lies between North America and Europe. I found that the place is cold and happy, and the water crunches below my step. There is a popular myth here among the children that if you don't receive clothing on Christmas Eve, then you will be killed by the Yule Cat. This effective folklore is commemorated by a large statue in the town centre. During my adventure, I discovered a lake not far from the Yule Cat statue. It was there that I first saw swans that were not under the ownership of the Queen of England. Subsequently, they were rude, mannerless animals that would bite and attack one another at any given opportunity. Like scenes from John Smith's Black Tower, when staying on this island, you are continuously watched by the Hultgrim's Kirke, or Church on the Hill. A rather grand structure that owns a large organ with 5,275 pipes. Overall, its watchful eyes don't amalgamate into much of anything. I've also noticed a friendly number of cats around the island. Perhaps distasteful in light of their murderous folklore, but lovable nonetheless. They too watch over this town. In fact, sometimes they meet with the church to discuss the town's rare imperfections.
weeks later, I was sent to another island. Having just swam into shore, I discovered a group of purple sandpipers. They washed their feet in puddles of seawater and enjoyed a sporadic meal of seaweed. At one point, a seemingly reincarnated director looked puzzled at my digital camera and wanted to inquire further. However, he was quickly driven away by two fiercely critical friends. Throughout my journey, I had heard several rumours that the individual who will save us all had been making improvised appearances on the beaches of this town. Initially, I rejected this gossip as pure entertainment, as I was too focused on my recordings of this place to consider such a rumour. However, later that day, I decided it may be helpful to my research if I could find a shark to interview about their opinion. So I took the short walk down to the rock pools of the low tide. It was there that I met them. They told me they were trying to find the rock that would save us all. Thank you.
Chapter 1 and 2 have now been written, but they do not explain the things I intend them to. So I've been sent to write Chapter 3 in a capital city. I arrived 4 days ago and have been sat at this desk for the past 5 hours. On my second day here, I thought it would be best to collect more footage for Vala. So I took the T train to the old town. Strangely, when it began to rain outside, a miniature version of myself appeared on the desk next to the notebook. But I... No, sorry. That's not true. Fuck. The other day, I tried to escape this desk, but ended up lost in a snowfield with a pair of horses to keep me company. I've come to the painful conclusion that, like all capitals that I have seen in my short life, this city is a ruined place. I wish for nothing more than to finish my work and retreat back to my home. However, having said that, this morning I discovered a mini wood outside of the capital city. It was there that I found several Gotland rabbits. These attractive animals are not native to this capital. They are the descendants of pets let loose by their owners, and their beauty subsequently feels as though it is a much needed relief. However, soon after recording this footage, I was told that this city's government has taken over as the rabbit's natural predator. They have recently decided to kill between 3,000 to 6,000 every year and send their bodies to a heating plant in Karlskoga, which incinerates them into biofuel production. I have been struggling to add descriptions to the footage that I have gathered. I have made several renditions of this film, and with each one, they seem to become more and more intimate. The sandpipers told me to be cautious when trying to describe the things that I can see. They warned me that it could ruin the beauty. I cannot possibly convey the things that I want to in this medium. It is impossible. Father. The rabbits. I miss the rabbits. It was Christmas then. The one who will save us greeted me at the gate.
The one who will save us.
I know you told me to write this, but I can't.
At the gate.
I can't write this.
I know you told me to write this, but I can't. I am writing this. It is being written.
Suddenly my table turned into me.
Father, I stumbled upon the purple sandpipers.
My own heart. Father, Bergman.
Suddenly my table turned into me.
Father,
suddenly
my table turned into me. I met with
this
them
island.
On the tide. I'm reincarnated. I can't even write on this island.
I love them. I met with them and my own heart is being written.
Vala.
Vala. I love you. I love you. I love you. Father. Later that evening, I decided that Vala was finished and that it would be best for me to dance.